Hello students, this is the third video of our module 1 and in this video I'm going to explain you about the concepts of computer components and memory. And in the last video I was explaining you about the bits, bytes and words, and the bandwidth is nothing but it is the mode of transmission or rate of transmission of a number of bits through the communication channel in bits per second, how many bits are being transferred on a communication channel per second is nothing but the bandwidth. Okay, coming to the computer components, so we have a block diagram of a computer here. So we have input unit, then central processing unit and output unit. So data, it will be flowing from the input unit. Through the input unit, it enters into the CPU and there it will be processed. And later from there, we are going to output the information, useful information through the output unit. So this is how the data will be flowing. So first it will be transferred from the input unit, then later it will be given to the CPU, and from CPU it will be processed, and that information which will be transferred through the output unit. And in CPU again you have three units. One is memory unit, then control unit and arithmetic and logic unit. So the data, whatever will be sent through the input unit to the memory unit, it will be stored in the memory unit. So that memory unit, it will be sending that data and a set of instructions to through the control unit. That is the control unit, it will be sending the signal, and based on those signals the data will be transferred. And it will be given to the arithmetic and logic unit if any arithmetic and logical operations has to be performed. Then later once it is performed and we are going to get the result, again once again it has to be sent to the memory unit for the storage, and later from there it will be transferred to the output unit. So this is here, this is the ALU, arithmetic and logic unit, this is the control unit, and these are the memory units, and here we are going to get the data and we are going to store them. Then coming to the central processing unit, it has three units, as I told you: control unit, arithmetic and logic unit, and also registers. So these registers, again we have different types of registers. MAR stands for memory address register, MDR stands for memory data register and accumulator, and the program counter, general purpose registers. Then coming to the central processing unit, how it works. First, the CPU, it will be consisting of three basic units: control unit, arithmetic logic unit and memory unit. Input is given through the input device to CPU, and control unit controls the communication within the ALU and memory unit, and also it decides which circuit has to be activated at that particular point of time. For reading instruction, it uses fetch execute mechanism. Then control unit gets the instructions from the memory, and the control unit decides what to do of that instructions and transfers it. If any ALU, that is arithmetic and logical instructions, are required, then it will be transferring to the ALU unit. ALU performs the various arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and logical operations like AND, OR, NOT, and NAND, etc. And also it will be on that instructions, whatever instructions will be transferred to that ALU unit. And results of ALU are again stored in the memory or the registers for its further operations. After completing the instruction, stored results are passed to the output device. To synchronize all these operations, CPU will be having its own system clock. That is, it will be mentioning at what time what instruction has to be executed, what data has to be transferred from which unit to the which unit. So everything will be maintained by a single system clock. Then coming to what exactly it does, it will be store the CPU, it executes the stored instructions which are called as programs, and tells rest of the computers what to do. Then executes arithmetic calculations and data manipulations, holds the data and instructions which are in the current use, and also it is responsible for storing and retrieving the informations on disk and other media. Then coming to the memory unit, so once we are clear with the central processing unit, what it does and how it does, then we will move on with the memory unit. And this memory, in our computer, we have two types of memories actually. So one is primary memory and the second one is a secondary memory. So primary memory, it is the one which is connected with the computer directly. That is, in the memory unit, it will be in, present in the CPU. And this memory, again, it is divided into two types. One is RAM, the other one is ROM. RAM is temporary memory, whereas ROM is a permanent memory. So RAM is volatile memory. That is, whenever the power goes off, the whatever data will be stored in RAM, it will be vanished and it will not be available for the users. Whereas ROM means always the data will be present, it will be stored. And it is non-volatile memory. And RAM, again, we have two different types of RAM. They are static RAM and dynamic RAM. And ROM, again, it is of different types, like erasable programmable read-only memory, electrically erasable programmable read-only memory, and now we have ultraviolet electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. Similarly, coming to the secondary memory, we have different types, like hard disk drives, then SSDs, then compact disks, then floppy disks, magnetic tapes, optical disks. So everything will be coming under the secondary memory, which can be detached from the computer system. Whenever we want to store large amount of data, then we are going with the secondary storage memory. Then more about primary memory we will see now. Made by electronic semiconductor devices. So these primary memory, it is made by semiconductor devices. As I have told you, the smallest unit of storage of the bits is nothing but cell, semiconductor cells, so which are used for storage purpose. This primary memory, it is also made by electronic semiconductor devices, and directly it will be communicating with the CPU of the computer, and it is faster when it is compared with the secondary storage devices or secondary memory, and it is very costly when it is compared with the secondary memory. Then primary memory, as we have as I have already explained you, it is divided into two types, RAM and ROM. And RAM, again, it is divided into SRAM and DRAM, and ROM is divided into PROM, EPROM and EEPROM. Then coming to RAM first, that is random access memory. So this is a temporary memory, and this is and it reads and writes the memory. This memory is read and writes the memory, and it is a volatile memory. That is, whenever the power goes off, whatever contents will be stored in RAM, it will be vanished. The programs and data that the CPU requires during the execution of a program are stored in this type of memory. So only for the temporary purpose only, it will be stored during the execution part. And RAM, it has two different types, as I told you, DRAM and SRAM. So we have the differences here. So it is constructed, DRAM is constructed by the tiny capacitors that leak electricity, and SRAM is constructed by the circuit similar to D flip-flops. DRAM requires a recharge very few milliseconds to maintain its data, holds its content as long as the power is available, this SRAM. DRAM is inexpensive, whereas SRAM is expensive. So DRAM is slower than SRAM. SRAM is faster than DRAM. DRAM can store many bits per chip. SRAM cannot store many bits per chip. So DRAM is uses less power, whereas SRAM, it will be using more power. DRAM generates less heat. SRAM generates more heat. And DRAM used for main memory, SRAM is used for cache memory. So these are the differences between random access memory. Then coming to the read-only memory, we have non-volatile memory, and it is a non-volatile memory. It is a permanent memory, and the instructions and informations will be stored by the manufacturers in this type of memory. So what are the different types of read-only memories we have? PROM, EPROM, EEROM, EEPROM, and UVPROM. So these are the different types of memories which we have, that is programmable read-only memory. Programmable read-only memory means only once we can program it, later we cannot change the contents. But nowadays, whatever we are getting, we can erase the contents and we can again reprogram it, or we can again manipulate the changes in it. Electrically erasable means we will be requiring electrical power in order to erase the contents of the read-only memory and store the new contents in it. Then electrically erasable programmable, we can also erase as well as we can again enter the new programs or new data into that. And ultraviolet programmable read-only memory is the new technique which is being used in our read-only memory. Then coming to the differences between the RAM and ROM. So as to I have told you in like a data retention, working type, use, speed, CPU interaction, size and capacity, used and users and accessibility and cost. So based on that, we have the difference between the RAM and ROM. So RAM is volatile, whereas ROM is non-volatile. Then data stored in RAM will be retrieved and altered, but in ROM, it cannot be, it can only be read. It cannot be retrieved. Used to store the data that has to be currently processed by the CPU temporarily. It stores the instructions required during the bootstrap of the computer. It is a high-speed memory, whereas ROM is slower when it is compared with RAM. CPU